वी कम टू इज नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज, मीन्स नॉन इन्फेक्शियस डिजीज, द डिजीज विच आर नॉन ट्रांसफरेबल एंड डिजीज विच डज नॉट अकर. लाइक सपोज अ पर्सन हैज इट, यू कैन वेर नाइसली मिक्स विद दैट पर्सन. If that person touches you, if you have something from his plate also, nothing will happen. But because the disease that he's having is not transferred, cannot be transferred from his body to a healthy body. Now in this we have like deficiency due to nutrients. Okay, so that is your a disease definitely, like rickets, like night blindness, like beriberi or scurvy. The person is suffering from due to lack of some vitamin, or maybe goiter, or maybe anemia. The person is suffering from that disease, but he cannot communicate, he cannot transfer it to another person. So this is what is non-communicable disease. So the first one we have is deficiency of nutrients. If a person is not taking nutrients and another healthy person is taking all the nutrients, the disease cannot transfer. The second one is we have is malfunctioning of the body organs. When the body organ, a part of the body is not working properly, let us say the heart, or maybe the liver, or maybe the pancreas is not working properly, or maybe one leg, or maybe one arm. Okay, so it is not working properly, malfunctioning of an organ in the body, that also is a non-communicable disease. Why? Because that cannot get transferred to another person. Then you have fever, normal fever that we have, that also does not get transferred from one person to another person. And the last one we have is allergy. Allergy is also non-communicable. I may be allergic to something, something particular, and other members of my family who are living with me, staying with me, staying in close contact with me, are not having that allergy because their body does not react to that particular substance. Maybe a particular food, let us say lady's finger or brinjal, many people are allergic to it. But maybe a family, maybe the brother is allergic to the brinjal and the what you call this lady's finger. Maybe the sister does not have any allergic to that, or any the mother does not have the allergies to it. So in this way it does not get transferred. So allergy is a type of disease, a non-communicable disease, which does not communicate from one person to another person. So over here we have deficiency of carbohydrates. As I have said, we have deficiency of protein. Due to protein, that is your kwashiorkor and marasmus comes under this. And we have discussed that kwashiorkor, what happens in kwashiorkor, the person suffering from kwashiorkor. Now these two diseases are called, in short we call it as PEM, we call it as PEM, that is protein energy malfunctioning, protein energy malfunctioning. So or malnutrition. So in this way two vital nutrients are involved, one is carbohydrate and one is protein. So these two are important nutrient, which leads to lack of these two nutrients leads to the protein energy malnutrition. And this occurs to children, like kwashiorkor occurs to children below 1 year of age. It occurs to children of 1 to 3 years. It occurs to children 1 to 3 years, those who are above 1 year, but within 3 years of age, children, it occurs to them when they are not getting enough amount of food. And marasmus occurs to children below 1 year. Below 1 year, it occurs to children. Again, for the same reason, the child is not getting enough amount of nutrition, enough amount of protein, enough amount of carbohydrate. So there are two different symptoms. There are different symptoms that the child gets. So in kwashiorkor, we have protruding belly. The belly bulges out. The body is very skinny, but the belly bulges out. So protruding belly, or we say it as pot belly. The hands and legs becomes very, very thin and long. It becomes very, very thin and long. The growth is stunted. The growth is stunted means dwarf. The person does not grow. Has to be, because there is lack of protein, there is lack of carbohydrate. The person, the child, feels fatigued and tired and weak. So because energy, the child is not getting any energy because the food does not have is not replenishing that energy that the child needs. So that is there. Then you have your loss of appetite. The child does not feel like eating anything. The child also have mental retardation. So the brain is not developing properly. According to age, the brain is not developing. It is developing very, very slowly. So these are what you call the symptoms of Kwashiorkor. The symptoms of marasmus is poor muscle development. You can see the ribs. You can see the bones of the ribs. The fat is very, very less, almost no fat under the skin. So the ribs are very much visible. The legs are very weak. The child is unable to stand properly. There is loss of appetite. There is anemia. There is underweight. Again, mental retardation. And resistant to diseases. The child is unable to resist any kind of diseases. It has to be because from inside the child is not properly nourished properly. It cannot resist to any kind of diseases. So often the child falls sick. Then we have deficiency due to diseases caused due to vitamins, as we have already mentioned, vitamin A, B, C, D, E and K. And I have told you that it does not, as I have done before, that night blindness for vitamin A, beriberi and skin diseases and scurvy and rickets and hemorrhage. All these are related to the deficiency of vitamins. Deficiency of minerals also, we have like calcium, that is brittle bones, phosphorus also, body weakness and brittle bones, sodium, again this is an important thing, sodium, dehydration, that is why we take common salt in our food. What does it do? Although it is required in very, very less amount. In very, very less amount it is required by the body, but it is required by the body, otherwise it will call dehydration. If we remember that when a person is dehydrated, the ORS solution that is given to the person contains salt and sugar. The salt controls the dehydration level and the sugar gives the energy for the person to stay alive and to fight against that dehydration. Potassium, again that is also muscle weakness and paralysis, that means it is affecting the nerves. And iron, if a person is does not having iron, it is having a disease called anemia. Iodine, as I told you, the goiter and fluorine is tooth decay.